Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be trying the Paperclip challenge. Unfortunately, people don't know what it is, and a lot of people think it's a scam. And you will see in this video, I have lots of struggles, and yeah. So the first thing I started off with is the lollipop candy, because I looked around and I saw it was the cheapest thing that I could find. So, unfortunately, many people, you know, they, like, canceled. Okay, so I just cut to until somebody actually is willing to trade me. And I had to use the I'm a YouTuber thing because, honestly, nobody is really, like, helping me here, you know? So basically, I traded the lollipop candy for the 2020 party hat, and it was a success. So the next thing I did was I changed my name because I feel like it was an easier way to show people like what I was doing. And then afterwards, I would say like, oh, this is gonna be on a video and stuff like that. And by the way, guys, I am using my other account because that one is actually at a higher level, so I can actually trade. And then this one, actually, the transition between this trade and the next one wasn't too bad. It wasn't a lot of people who wouldn't trade, and there were a bunch of helpful people.
I'm on my own, broken and alone. I feel the rain crashing down.
So now I've got the seashell hair clips. Yeah. And so that was my third. That's my third item now. So yeah, let's see what I get next. Cause the flames will burn us. I thought you were the one for me. Luckily, this one was actually pretty fast, and so I traded the seashell hair clips for the strappy Wonder Berry heels, and yeah. Okay, this is when I started getting tired, and then people were like, you know, they didn't really want to trade for them, and etc. Okay, so after a very long while, I found this really nice girl, and she was super nice to me, and yeah, so I traded these strappy Wonder Berry heels for the ballroom entrance skirt, and I was like, that's such a lucky find. And she was so sweet to me. She's probably like one of the nicest traders that I had. Let me tell you, it took a long time to trade, find someone who is willing to trade this one as well. And then you'll see in the future, I've got so many trades that people tried to trade me the ballroom entrance for other things that I've got. And I don't know, I might have downgraded. I don't really know. I'm not really good with the word, like how much things are worth in Royale as I am with other games. This was the hardest trade ever. So many people have the skirt, and like, it's hard to find people who are willing to trade. I was like, please don't cancel on me, and this one finally was it, and I got the cherry blossom kimono skirt. Little did I know, this one was also hard to trade. nobody wanted like either of these, and I felt like I should have just honestly ended it here. But the problem was I was stubborn, and I just wanted to get something good. And so afterwards I may have downtraded a little bit because I just got super tired and nobody would want to buy the cherry kimono skirt. And well, let's see. See, this is an example where people try to trade me the cherry blossom kimono skirt for the ballroom entrance one. I don't know if I downtraded for the Rose Roll to the cherry blossom, but like honestly nobody would buy it, so I think it's fine. After years of what seemed like looking for someone who would be kind enough to trade the cherry blossom kimono skirt, there was this girl, and I don't know her username, how to like pronounce it, because it's just AGJABN07. But she was super nice, and she like gave me the heirloom sleeves for free. And I don't know, I felt kind of guilty, so I just offered her 100 diamonds for it. So yeah, that's how I got the enchanting heirloom sleeves. So even afterwards, I felt like that I wasn't gonna trade for the, like I wasn't gonna trade the heirloom sleeves. I felt like I still had to trade the cherry kimono skirt. So you're seeing me like doing all this. The problem was there was a lot of people that spoke a different language. I think mainly it was like Spanish or something. And I don't know, it was annoying because I couldn't communicate with them and I couldn't like tell them what I was doing. And again, a lot of people thought that this was like a scam or something. So yeah, and a lot of people did try to scam me. And at this point, I was super tired and I didn't even think that this girl would like accept, but she did, and I got the Dear Dolly gloves. Unfortunately for me though, people, you know, they just didn't want it, or they would try to get it for something lower. And I mean, there were a lot of nice people, but I think there were still more people who wanted to take advantage of other people. And no, I guess that's just how life is. So yeah. Okay, so you guys saw the shortened version, but in all, this took 2 hours to make, and I'm tired, so there's gonna be part 2. Bye!